We are in beautiful Liar River Campground. It's a Department of Natural Resources campground. Been around for years. It is steelhead country. And of course, here it is, Christmas Eve. We're camping on Christmas Eve, and there have been a stream of fishermen coming into the campground last night, throughout the day here today. It is a gem of a Department of Natural Resources site. It isn't all that isolated. It is just west of Joyce. There are some lovely cabins on the creek around the tree here. So it isn't, one doesn't get that feeling of being exquisitely isolated being here, but sometimes there's a comfort in knowing that, hey, there is some human traffic coming through a place. Maybe you don't have to worry about bear critters if there are human critters so close at hand. In any case, this is a winter camping experience. Legitimately winter in that December 21st was, just 3 days ago, this being the 24th. And we're in the middle of a three-day camp. Our plan today is to go to Modoc Beach. What is it? Get my name straight here, folks. Murdoch Creek, Murdoch Beach. It is also Department of Natural Resources land. It's just up the way, just down Highway 112, this exquisite scenic byway that takes people from Port Angeles to Clallam Bay. Almost every inch of which is scenic and beautiful. Lots of twists and turns and views of mountains and views of the Strait of Juan de Fuca. Murdoch Beach has a little hiking trail down the water, a small parking lot. Beach to hunt certain fossilized rocks, as I understand. We're going to be there shortly. Maybe I'll vlog about that here later. But we also plan to stop at Sadie Creek. We do have a Jeep. We're not necessarily big into rigorous off-road jeeping kinds of experiences, but the Jeep does get us to places that average car may not get us to. And we just got done talking about a half hour ago with Ed Shire. He is the warden and recreational manager, I'm assuming, for this DNR area. And he was speaking with great pride about Sadie Creek. They've got 5 new campsites. We did see them last week when we were in the area. On the oval, close to the entrance, they talked about the miles and miles of trails and the fact that some of the current logging that's going on, and this of course is trust lands, it has as a purpose to raise funds for schools and other public benefits. One of the benefits, of course, of logging is that it does clear up a view, and that some of the logging that's currently being done will give you incredible views of Lake Crescent. So here we are north of Lake Crescent, but there's 2 mountain ridges and a valley in between, and apparently the clear cut being done currently will open up possibilities for recreational sites, and they have plans in the work, DNR does, plans in the works to take advantage of that clear cut and create some recreational sites that to embrace the view. I am so impressed with this stretch of road, Highway 112. There's a whole series of recreational areas here, Salt Creek Recreational Area being one of them. That's just the first as you head down 112. Lovely beach. It's a popular place for divers. It has a large campground. The campground's a little too formal for our tastes. It's been around for years. Like a lot of these campgrounds, it looks a little bit much loved. This Lyre River, also been around for years, but has a much more rustic feeling. Fewer sites. We're in number 14. Again, the water's right there. You got a sound machine for good sleeping at night. Here on the 24th of December, the low temperature this morning was 32. Not bad. We have slept in temperatures as low as 24 so far this late fall, early winter. But that was in eastern Washington. So again, Lyre River, Murdoch Beach, oh, my mind goes blank. Sadie Creek, of course, we just talked about. And on down the way, there's another point. Pointer Point? Is it something point? That we enjoyed last time we came through last week when we were camping up at Rosette. So, I wanted to talk a little bit about this channel. It's called Washington Secret Places, Nature and Community Washington Secret Places being the full name. What is a secret place? I had a friend say, you know, secret places shouldn't be promoted. They should be kept a secret so that resources aren't threatened, they won't be overused, and the like. I told him all the places that we feature in our travels and on the videos that we do about them, substitute another word for secret. Special. These are special places. The reality is there are no truly secret places in this state. People have lived here for so long. People have enjoyed recreation in this state for so long that there are very few places, next to none, that you can say, oh my gosh, no one has ever been here. I've got to tell the world about this secret place, or may I have the opportunity to share the news about this lovely natural site, this natural setting. The reality is every lovely natural setting has been discovered and enjoyed by someone already. So our job is to value these sites, put in place laws, provide management for the continuity of the integrity of these sites, maintaining the resources in these sites through good governance. But my friend's comment about secret places made me think about the places that I do hold dear. And reflected on the fact that my desire is that more people get out into nature, leave their laptops, their televisions, their video games, their life of other pursuits in cities and towns, and on a regular basis enjoy nature, include nature in their week. That in my volunteer work, I have opportunity to be around some lovely youth, and I'm aware that for a lot of these youth, that they do not have the opportunity to come out into nature. In some cases, maybe they've never camped. It occurs to me that we are able to preserve natural lands, public lands in this state, as more people value the natural world that we have in this state. As I say, there's nothing in this state that is left to discover for the first time. I mean, loggers discovered places